In 2020, are we looking for another Migos album? Culture 3. Put it like this. I'll get into this. I was talking to my homeboy Lavelle about it.
Okay.
And
shout out Lavelle.
He was asking me, he's like, do you think that Migos still have their position in hip hop? Just the music aspect of it. I don't think that they do. I'm curious because when they do come out again, I know that they'll do some numbers.
Right.
But they haven't had a hit collectively
right.
in a while.
Right.
And solo-wise,
last hit you think they had as a group? I'm just thinking. Bad and Bougie?
Nah. The Walking Like I Talk It. Was that
a Walking hit? Like It, I don't know if Walking Like I Talk It was a hit, though. They kind of forced it on us.
Forced it.
Versus Bad and Bougie was an organic hit.
So
it didn't take no work to push that.
Yeah. So I would say Bad and Bougie. If we're talking about like hit, and I hate to say that because it was number one, but
really,
after Bad and Bougie, even the songs that were on that Culture, the first Culture album, how many were like hits?
What, the second one, you mean?
The first one. Bad and Bougie was on the first Culture.
Was it?
Yeah. Culture 2 had Walking Like I Talk It, Narcos, and Stir Fry. Stir Fry, was that a hit?
I wouldn't call it a hit.
Okay.
It
charted.
But that's money makes it do that.
And Motorsport.
Yeah.
Motorsport.
Now, Motorsport was hard, but it was because it had Cardi
and Nicki. That was really a Cardi and Nicki song.
And really, them feuding made that
record hot. Let's just say Bad and Bougie was their last
big hit.
You know, but in for Culture 3 to drop, I feel just like how Wayne is right now. Migos have also, in addition with Young Thug, we're going on as far as radio and the newer generation.
Okay.
They've influenced the game.
And right.
It's not just a Migos style. That is the style of rap.
Correct.
You know what I'm saying?
It is.
So it's so many artists. Look how many artists then came out since then. You got DaBaby, Megan Thee Stallion, Roddy Ricch,
Lil Baby.
Yeah. It's so many different artists
that
came out since then.
Yo.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So NBA YoungBoy.
Yeah.
So it's I feel like Migos
Rhapsody. She don't really go that way, but I just wanted to shout out.
How dare you mention her with those?
I just wanted to shout out a female artist.
Okay,
that's all.
I got you. Ain't nothing wrong with
City Girls.
Yeah. So
Saweetie,
where do we in Culture 3, do you think it'll make an impact?
I think Culture 3 will have at least two or three records that go up in the club, and then the rest of the album gonna be the way all their albums be.
Regular.
I mean, they don't make classic albums. They put out dope singles, and then
do you think Migos put out a dope a hit?
Yeah.
By just those three?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay.
Yeah, I think so.
I don't think so.
You don't think the Migos could put out a hit?
They haven't in the last couple of years.
I think so. Definitely think so. By themselves, the Migos could manufacture
a hit. Then how come they haven't done it yet? You said manufacture.
Well, no, come out with a hit.
If they could, how come they haven't done it lately?
I mean, that's because all their hits have features on them, though.
Stir Fry didn't have a feature.
Yeah, and it wasn't a hit. Walk It Like I Talk It was a hit, though. That grew
because of Drake.
Right.
But I'm asking, can they do, how? They put out Stripper, or what was it, Stripper Bowl?
Yeah, but that was, they didn't work that record.
Yeah, they
put that out strictly for the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, anyway, shout out to Migos.
Shout out to the Migos, QC and all that.
Don't give up, you gon' be on. Don't give up, give up. Don't give up, you gon' be on. Don't give up, give up. Don't give up, you gon' be on. Don't give up, give up. Don't give up, you gon' be on. Don't give up, give up, give up, give up.
I know you got doubts, but get to the bag. Just follow the dream and stick with the plan. I know you get worried, I know you get scared.